Guys, welcome to this video. Now, I'm very excited to be able to share this video with you because in this video, I'll be talking about Rain, which is a cryptocurrency exchange based in Bahrain, and it is also licensed by the Central Bank of Bahrain, right? Now, Rain offers the opportunity for you to be able to purchase cryptocurrency, let's say, for example, Bitcoin, BTC, also like Litecoin, LTC, XRP, Ripple, and of course Ether for Ethereum. Now, specifically, why does Rain has an advantage over other cryptocurrencies? Mainly because it's licensing requirements by the central bank, which means it must follow strict regulation by the central bank for KYC requirements, identification requirements, and so on. So in this video, we're going to go ahead and talk about how to actually log into the Rain platform and how to make different purchases of different cryptocurrencies for you to be able to improve your investment positions using crypto assets. All right, so let's go ahead and get started here. Okay guys, so let's go ahead and get started on the Rain platform. So as I said earlier, Rain is a cryptocurrency exchange which allows you to conduct and purchase transactions for Bitcoin, Ethereum, and other cryptocurrencies using their platform. Now, it's only available for the GCC countries, which is Bahrain, Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, Oman, and the UAE, of course, with the exception of Qatar. So if you have a bank account and if you live in those countries, you'll be able to use the Rain platform. If you do not, you will not be able to use the platform at this time. But Rain are working on expanding their service to include other countries going forward. All right, so let's go ahead and continue here. So this is essentially the Rain screen when you first log in. And let's go ahead and let me just go ahead and try to sign in here. So the initial screen here tells you like all the different cryptocurrency, their latest cryptocurrency rates in basically with the reflection of the local currencies of those GCC countries. So KWD is Kuwaiti dinars, AED is obviously Emirates dirhams, SAR is Saudi riyals, and so on, and OMR is Omani riyals, and so on. And of course, BHD is Bahrain dinars. All right. So let's go ahead and let me just go. Okay. So if you decide to open an account, you can open as a personal account or an institutional account. If you open a personal account, they're going to ask you for a government issued ID. So your passport. And I believe they might actually ask you for a address, a proof of address. Although I heard that that's no longer the case. It used to be that way when I first opened an account with them. But now I think they only require your passport ID, but two IDs. And then it will take them one day for them to be able to approve your ID and then grant you the access to the account for you to be able to make a purchase, right? So just keep in mind, it takes about one day, 24 to 48 hours for them to be able to approve your identification. That's also, of course, a regulation requirement by the central bank. So, if you want to go ahead and do that, you can, and then just you have to wait one day for you to be able to get that approval. So let me just go ahead and sign in here. Okay. All right. So now that I'm logged in, let me just adjust something here very quickly. Okay. Now that I'm logged in here, it gives me the total prices. And it also gives me the different accounts that I have. So each account represents a cryptocurrency account. So BTC is Bitcoin, right? So I have 0.00303960 Bitcoin balance, which is equivalent to BHD, which is Bahrain dinar, which is 6.125, which is about, I don't know, like $15-$20 worth of Bitcoin, right? And then you have Ether, which I have zero, and then LTC, which is Litecoin, which is a very, very popular cryptocurrency right now, and that's zero. And then you've got XRP, which is Ripple. And of course, this is my BHD account, which means that I have 1.2 BD in the balance of the account right now. Now, keep this in mind. BHD account, this means this is what I have in terms of BHD, or Bahrain dinars, in the Rain account, which means I can purchase cryptocurrency based on what I have in this balance. If I want to top up this balance and I want to add more to it, I'll have to go and do a deposit to the account, like transfer funds and deposit from bank, for example. And that will allow me to be able to transfer more money into the account. So, for example, I want to be able to transfer, okay, BHD, which is my local bank. And let's say I want to be able to do let's say 300 BD or BHD, which is about almost $1,000, right? And I'll choose my source bank. So I got two banks here connected. So I might do like BBK, for example, and I'll hit continue. And that will take me to a page to confirm that I want to be able to transfer 300 BD from my bank account into my Rain balance BHD account, right? And once I do that, then it'll give me confirmation. I have to go to my bank's online banking service and make a transaction. Now let's actually do it here just to give you guys an idea. So I hit continue here, and then this will take you to, it should take you to the next page, but it's not for some reason. It's still loading. Okay, it's still loading. It's a bit slow for some reason. Maybe they're doing some system updates, but this will take you to the page where they give you confirmation, and it will also list for you the Rain's bank account detail in Bahrain, right? Which is actually a BBK account, right? So they will give you the bank details of Rain, and then you have to go to your online banking platform or system, and you have to transfer the 300 BD from your local bank account into the Rain account, which they will list you in that deposit page, right? And then the transfer will be completed. So, okay, here's what happened here. So basically, this confirms that I made a request to confirm a deposit of 300 BD or BHD from my BBK and destination of BHD account. And here is, okay, there's still get instructions, and that's the total. It takes 1 to 4 business days, but that's in most cases, which I've done, it takes about 1 day for them to receive the amount, right? It takes about 1 day. A maximum, I think I had a friend who took some 2 days for him to receive the account. So then you go get instructions, and that will basically load the page. And this will show you now the account number of Rain, and this is the recipient, and which is Rain. This is the recipient name, and that's their address. That's their IBAN number, which corresponds to the bank account of Rain. That's their account number, that's their bank name, and the SWIFT code, and the currency. And that means now you're able to go to your local bank account and make the transfer of 300 BD, and it will go directly into Rain's account, which will automatically be assigned to your account, user account here on the Rain platform, okay? And then that will say, and then what's going to happen is when you go back to your account the next day, you're going to see that here it's going to say increase by 300 BD. This will allow you now to be able to purchase cryptocurrency in using this balance, right? And this allows you to start doing the purchases. Once you have the amount deposited, you'll be able to do the purchases right there on the platform. All right? In the next quick video, I'll be able to show you the different transactions that you can do and how to do them and how to make a purchase. And I'll be able to show you the different fees which Rain platform charges whenever you buy or sell any cryptocurrency that you want to be interested in to do right online. All right, so I'll see you guys in the next video.